Today, we're diving into an exciting solution for all Bolt.new users who struggle with integrating their projects into GitHub. For those new to Bolt.new, it's a powerful tool for quickly building web applications or web projects. But there's one big limitation. There's no direct GitHub integration. But why do we need GitHub? It's because GitHub provides version control, making it easy to track changes, collaborate with others, and maintain a professional development workflow. So the problem with Bolt right now is we cannot update or import it to GitHub directly. That's where the Bolt to GitHub Chrome extension comes in. It's an open source solution and it's currently under review in Chrome Web Store. So by the time you watch this, I hope it's already reviewed. But whatever happens, anyone can install this locally by following the simple installation steps outlined here in the GitHub repository README. The extension takes automation to the next level, from zip file interception to secure GitHub integration. It's designed for simplicity and efficiency. So let me demonstrate how to use this. So I will use this with this particular Bolt.new project. So right now, as I mentioned, this is pending review in Chrome Web Store. So what we can do, regardless if it's accepted or not, is to install this locally. So what I will do is go to GitHub and then I will follow these steps like I'm a new user. I will go to my terminal and it says there that I need to check my version, the node version. I have version 20, which is more than enough based on the minimum requirements. So now it says here that I can git clone this repository. I will copy it, I will paste it in my terminal, and then I will enter it. So this is assuming that you have Git desktop installed. If you do, you can access this Git bash terminal and you can do the same way that I've been doing right now. So let's go to that directory, cd, and then npm install. I will simply type it in here. So this will install the necessary packages and dependencies for this project. Let's wait for a bit. And then it says here, the next step is to run npm run build. Since as a user, I might not need to develop or change anything in this extension, I will use npm run build. But if you're a developer and want to change anything, you're welcome to use npm run watch, which will continuously run the build every time you made some changes. So let's just wait for a bit. All right, so it's done. Now let's go to the next step. So open Chrome and go to Chrome extensions. So I will copy this and basically this is it. So I can just simply paste it again. And then here you have to click on this developer mode here in order for these three buttons to appear. So let me click on load unpack. And then I will navigate to where my project is, which is in this folder. And then I will select this disk. And then without selecting anything else, select folder. So if every step has been followed, we will be able to see this Bolt to GitHub extension here. And if we go to Bolt.new and refresh, we can see here now that we now have a new GitHub button here. If we click on it, it will ask us to configure the GitHub settings first. So that means we need to click this or go to the settings. And if you're new to GitHub, you can follow this step. If you don't have a GitHub account, you can click on this. And if you have an account but don't have a GitHub repository, you can click on this link. And then I will create something like 2048 game. And then I will create a repository. So I will remember this repository name. I will go back to Bolt, click on this again, and then says here that I need to generate a GitHub token. So all of these instructions here is also available in the GitHub repository. So if you click on that, it will automatically redirect you to this page in GitHub where you can create a new personal access token. So you can leave all these settings as is and generate a token. And then click on this copy. Let's go back to Bolt. Let's go back to our extension here. So let me pin it in here. So you can also click on this. And now I have all the information I need. I can paste in the GitHub token here. I can collapse this guide. I can put in my username here, GitHub AI driven coder. And then the repository name, if I'm not mistaken, is 2048 game. And you can leave the branch main because that's the usual and default branch. So I can save the settings now. And if I go to home, the extension is now ready to use. So even if I refresh this, for example, the button is there. And if we click on our extension, it's ready to use. So all the information of our GitHub repository is already there. So now what will happen if I click on this? So let's see. If I click on this, the extension will ask for confirmation. Just click upload. And now it's pushing everything to GitHub. Nice. And if we go to our repository in GitHub and refresh, we can see here that we now have 2 commits. So now we can go to Bolt and try to fix this again, just to emulate that we are doing some updates to our real project. So let me ask Bolt again to please fix the number blocks. So again, this is just a simulation. Let's imagine that we are satisfied with the changes Bolt did. We can click on it again. Now it's committing the changes again. So you might be wondering, is this secure? Yes, security is our top priority. Your GitHub token that you have provided here is securely stored in your own browser's local storage. And the extension only communicates with GitHub. No other external services or servers are involved. So this extension only works between you, your browser, and GitHub. While Bolt may implement similar functionality in the future and could even be developing it now, this extension continues to evolve. Future plans include support for multiple repositories, enhanced error reporting, and many more. But right now, it's working well. Alright, so you can check out the GitHub repo in our documentation for more details. There are more details here, some troubleshooting and some other resources. We also have some tutorials here, like we talked about in this video. And if you found this helpful, start the repo. You can start the repo here. And of course, if you found this video helpful, don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and share this to your friends and other people that might benefit from this extension and from this video itself. Thank you for watching. Happy coding.